Joshua, the second chapter, verse 1. It says, Joshua, the son of Nun, sent out a shipment, two men to spy secretly, saying, go view the land, even Jericho. And they went and came into a harlot's house named Rahab and lodged there. You may be seated. Praise God. Hallelujah. When I was going through this word and was studying this, you know, it showed me that God can use whoever he desires.
Amen.
So,
here in the scriptures, and they went and came into a harlot's house.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. Anybody know what a harlot is, right?
Yeah.
Come on. Praise God. Hallelujah. The teacher told us. Y'all heard it, right? She's a prostitute. Amen. Hallelujah. But how many know that we've been harlots in our lives?
Oh, yeah.
I ain't going to get too many amens right there. Hallelujah. Because y'all want to think harlots being women, but men, y'all been some whores too.
Hello.
Hallelujah. Y'all don't want to talk up in the kids. Go on now. We can have church.
Come on.
Up in here, we can have some church.
Come on now.
But here, God is showing that he can use whoever desired him.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Rahab was a harlot. Rahab came from a background where she used her gift of a charm and her gift of charisma, hallelujah, to bring people in and bring people out.
Come on.
As a matter of fact, her house was set on the wall of Jericho.
That's right.
I was like, wow. So she made sure she saw all the men when they came in.
Uh-huh.
Oh, y'all know how it is.
Come on.
When somebody new on the block. And say, I ain't just talking about the women and the men's too. Let somebody move down here from New York or Florida somewhere. Everybody checking them out. So who that? Rahab was set and she was strategic because she had a business. She was in an inn. She entertained it, folks. But I want you to know that no matter what your background is, God can use you.
Amen.
The Bible tells us, let's go to verse 2, praise God. Before I get into my topic, this is going to, I want to show you something. And it was told the king of Jericho, saying, behold, there came men in hither tonight of the children of Israel to search out the country. In other words, somebody knows and watching you.
All right. Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah. You might think you're getting away with stuff, but somebody actually see what you're doing.
All right. All right.
Can I get an amen there?
Amen.
You know, I've been creeping late at night, and somebody says, I saw you come.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Talk about you went to get gas, and you know ain't no gas station open.
Yeah.
All right. Hallelujah. You might see the curtains pull back a little bit, and somebody looking at you. Somebody's watching you. Somebody say, yeah, girl, I saw when you came in late last night. What that man you was with?
Uh-huh.
I can't cut you nosy. Y'all ain't got no nosy folks. Oh, we all got some nosy neighbors, praise God. Hallelujah. I might be one of them looking out my window. Who that passing by? Hallelujah. Right. Praise God. But Rahab, hallelujah, Rahab was someone that believed in God, mm-hmm. and God was going to use her. Mm-hmm. But the king was watching her too.
Yes.
Go to verse 3, because my topic is sold out to God. Watch somebody say, sold out to God.
Oh,
and the Bible says in verse 3, the king of Jericho sent unto Rahab, saying, bring forth the men that are come to thee. In other words, I know you know who's in town.
All right.
I know you know all and everybody business. So he sent down people down to her and say, bring the men forth, because I know they came to your house.
All right.
And she said, bring forth the men that are come to thee, which are entered into thy house, for they are come, they be come to search out all the country. Go to verse 4. And the woman took the two men and hid them and said, thus there came men unto me, but I was not whence there were. Mm-hmm. In other words, Rahab was putting her life at stake over somebody she didn't even know.
Uh-huh.
Y'all may believe in somebody and you don't know everything about them, but you can see the potential in them.
Amen.
Rahab was able to recognize gifts in men.
All right.
I know we always give her a bad story because of her profession. Hallelujah, but she had a gift in recognizing talent.
Come on.
So when the men came in, she said, you know what? I seen y'all before. I heard about y'all before. God is doing some miraculous things in y'all.
All right.
And he said, I want to get on y'all side.
All right.
So she said, I'm going to sell myself out to you.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, we got to get to a point in our life where we sold out for God.
Come on. Thank you.
this woman, the king came to her house, and she was willing to commit treason in order to follow God. In other words, somebody's going to reach God through you. Somebody don't even know God, but they're going to be able to see God in you. She never had a personal encounter with God, but she heard about God works in the children of Israel, and she came to believe God. In other words, Rahab believed in God from the works he did on behalf of Israel. Not only of the Red Sea, but also when he was fighting against the giant kings. Do y'all remember the giant kings in Numbers? You go look it up yourself in this 21st chapter. There was two kings. One of them name was Sihon, and the other name was OG. You know, the original gangster.
Yeah.
And both of them was kings. They were sons or offsprings of the angels that slept with men. So they were bigger than everybody else. But when Israel came through, Israel came to Sihon and said, look here, we don't want to have no beef with you. We just want to pass by.
Amen.
But Sihon means warrior. In other words, some people just don't like you, and they're going to fight you on every turn.
God.
There's some fights you can't avoid.
Right.
There's some conflicts you cannot avoid at all. You're just going to have to take it head on. Because some people is in your life to bully you. Anybody ever been bullied around here? Maybe you've been bullied by your supervisor. Maybe you've been bullied by some family member that of a higher patriarch or matriarch than you. You know, big brother, big sister, always picking on you. But after a while, you want to say enough. Come on, enough is
enough.
Hallelujah, I'm tired of all of this. I didn't want to pick a fight. I wanted to pass through. But since you want to bring it to me, hallelujah, I'm going to see this thing all the way through. Because the enemy has learned to recognize faith. Somebody need a shot right there. In other words, the enemy know God is on your side.
All right. Yeah.
And he want to do whatever he can to stop you when God is on your side.
Yeah.
Y'all can shout right there.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But this is Rahab recognizing, hallelujah, that God has favor on these people.
Right.
And some people are attracted to you because of the favor God has on your life. Ain't because you're the best looking thing in town. Hallelujah. Ain't because you got the most money, but you got favor on your life.
Yeah.
And when you got favor on your life, it's going to attract folks to you.
Oh, yeah.
You got to learn how to discern who's for you and who's against you.
Because
some people just want to take what you got.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. They just want to use you. Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on.
Well, I'm preaching that lesson. Right.
Yeah.
There's something you just got to be sold out to. Look at somebody and say, I'm selling out. And I ain't selling out in a bad way. You know how when, you know, your team go bad and you're not doing well, you know, like the Atlanta Falcons? I'm just throwing some shade. Just throwing some shade. Praise God. I hope Dallas win today. But you know, when a team is doing so bad, someone say, man, I'm done with them. They sold out. Hallelujah. But I ain't selling that. When I'm selling out for God, that means I'm giving it all to him. As a matter of fact, I'm doubling down on him. That's what God looking for, some people going to double down on him. Rahab said, I heard of all your exploits. I heard all the things you're doing. I wonder what God, hallelujah, a God like you must be not only God in earth, but a God in heaven as well.
Amen.
And she said, I'm getting on your side. You know how we got those bandwagoners? Sometimes it's good to be a bandwagon. If you're jumping on the right team. Anybody a Golden State Warrior fan in here? Only one? How about the LA Lakers? What about the Cleveland Cavaliers? Well, nobody like basketball. I better stick to football. Anybody a Dallas Cowboy fan up in here? Woo, woo. All right, that's all I need. We ain't got to talk about the rest of your teams. Hallelujah. But when Dallas start winning, all of a sudden you have all the bandwagoners start jumping on the team. Yeah, I used to be a Cowboy fan back in the 70s. But you don't jump over to some other team when they started winning. You know, everybody talking about they're a big Patriot fan, but there was a time the Patriot used to win nothing. Nobody would even want to associate with them. But all of a sudden, now you're a Patriot fan. Or whoever is winning at the time. People like to follow whatever's winning. You can shout right there. Hallelujah. People know how to get on the winning team.
Yeah.
This woman said, you know what? I've been looking at y'all. I've been watching y'all from a distance. I heard about all y'all's story. Because remember, she was in the profession of information.
Yes. Yes.
Hello. Y'all better watch where y'all put your head at.
Mm-hmm.
Say that. I'm going to say that a little
while. Hallelujah. Because pillow talk. And she was in the pillow talking business. So everybody who came in, they came in by Rahab's house. And Rahab, all the story of everything that was going on in the countryside. She know who was going in, who was with who was on, who's having some bad time with their spouse. Oh, come on. Who's having a bad time on their job? All right. Because y'all know how men and y'all talk.
Yes.
Y'all talk worse than women. And I ain't trying to beat the rock towards women. But we like give women a bad rep talking about women talk all the time. Man, get around a man. Hello. Oh, you can remember, right? You remember we was on the softball team together? Man, my boy like, oh, they just talk. Yep. And wonder why everybody know your business. Because you're a total whole team.
Oh,
wow.
And then you wonder why somebody trying to go in through your back door. Because you told me it was open. Oh, I'm going to leave that one alone right there. Praise God. But here, Rahab was in the process of getting information. And she got the information, and the spies came to her house. Mm-hmm. And because she heard a report of the Lord, she believed the report.
Yeah.
So God is establishing some folks just because he wants God to get into them.
Yeah.
Through you.
Yeah.
Yeah. What you're doing, people are watching you. They're seeing how you're handling your situations. They're seeing a struggle, whether you are telling that God is in control or you in control. Brother, you're giving praise in the midst of your problems. They're watching how you handle chaos. You know, you can say you change, but people watch your life.
All right.
Come on.
You can hook a Messiah all you want. You can jump around in church all you want. You can roll around on the floor all you want. You just be a rolling devil on the floor. People want to see what happened when you get up. Look at somebody and say, I'm getting up. And I ain't getting up in my own strength. I'm getting up in the strength of God. Because it was God that brought me through this situation.
Thank you, God.
She said, I heard about y'all, God. He defeated Sion. He defeated OG. He defeated that warrior in the long neck one. He defeated them through all the conflict, even though they was just trying to pass by. He defeated them. So I know God has favor on your life.
Amen.
Look at somebody and say, God has some enemy. He got some people in the enemy camp.
God got some people in the enemy camp.
Because I want to give you a different perspective. Rahab was in the enemy camp.
Uh-huh.
But God had somebody strategically placed in that camp to help his people. In other words, some of the people that you are calling the enemy, God's going to use them one day.
Thank you, though.
Y'all don't want to talk about that. Y'all want to talk about enemy be gone. Poof, be gone. Y'all want to destroy your enemy. But some of your enemies are going to help you in the long run. Some of your enemies have been designed to set you up for a blessing. So Rahab had to use the seed of faith. Look at somebody saying seed of faith.
Seed of faith.
That's what God wants you to activate today, is the seed of faith.
Seed of faith.
And when you activate the seed of faith, you want to get a harvest.
Oh, yes.
Because of what she did, hallelujah, God was able to bless her.
Yes.
Let's go down to verse 9. And she said unto them, unto the men, I know the Lord has given you the land, and your terror is falling upon us, and that all inhabitants of the land faint because of you. Verse 10. For we have heard how the Lord dried up the waters of the Red Sea for you. When you came out of Egypt, what you did unto the two kings of the Amorites, and they were on the other side, Jordan, Sihon, and Og, whom you utterly destroyed. In other words, she said, you know what? I'm on your side. I'm a sold out. I done lied to the king and hide you on the top of my roof. I'm sold out.
Yes.
In other words, we can say we sold out for something, but your actions speak loud.
Yes.
Are you willing to risk your life for your God?
Yes.
She was willing to risk. Treason was a capital punishment. You put everybody. everybody in the city at risk. Amen. But everybody in the city at risk heard the same story she heard. And she knows that she couldn't fight against God. Right. When God has a call on your life, all the fight you can put up, how are you going to stop what God has called on your life? There's been a lot of prayer over my life. Thank God for prayer. Because it was prayer that brought me out. Can I get an amen there? If it was not for prayer, hallelujah, I'd still be at John Poohall. Shooting pool, being broke. Going in my girlfriend's pocketbook, getting that money. She's my wife now. I'm telling myself. She done got it back 100-fold. Hallelujah. Glory. Just go down there and feed somebody else's pocket. But thank God for prayer. Prayer brought me out. Yeah. Somebody was praying on my behalf. Yeah. Hoping and praying and seeing something on the inside of me. If God would just use that young man right there, come on. Yeah. Yeah. He's going to save his whole household. Look at somebody and say, God's going to use me. To help save my household too. If he did it for Rahab, yes, he can do it for me. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. So it doesn't matter. Your past doesn't discount you or disqualify you from what God want to do. Because sometimes people are based on what you done in your past. Well, you can do something else in your future. Just because I was broke yesterday don't mean I'm going to be broke tomorrow. Just because I didn't finish school don't mean I can't own my own business. Hello. Just because I was slow the first day at work don't mean I can't be the supervisor later. Well, I want y'all to achieve higher than that. Let's get to be the CEO of the company. Hallelujah. There's a lot of people CEO of the company don't have education. Oh, come on. God give you wisdom. If you don't believe me, go ask Joseph. He ain't had no education, but he ruled the kingdom of Egypt. Yes. So I go and watch this. Let's go down to verse 12. Now, therefore, I pray you swear unto me by the Lord, since I have showed you kindness, that you will also show kindness unto my father's house and give me a true token. In other words, she went into contract with God through his people. And she said, look here, I'll help you because I know the God you serve can deliver me. Because in those days, when they came into the city, they wiped out everybody. But she said, I'm willing to put my family at risk that y'all want to win. I don't know about you, but if God is on your side, you're on the winning side. She put it all in the pot. Anybody ever gamble in here? Well, you put it all in the pot. Hello. That means you all in. And when you all in, and you win, or you go home. Or sit around the table, look broke mouth. Hoping somebody dollar falling off and you get back in. I used to gamble, that's why I can tell you all these things. Praise God. But she was sold out to the point like, look here, I'm putting everything in. Not only my life, but the life of my family. That the God I'm serving is the true and living God. And he's able to bring us out. Look at somebody and say, he's able to bring you out. All right, let's go to last verse. Let's go to Joshua. Hallelujah. 6 chapter, verse 22.
Thank you, God.
Joshua 6 and 22. When you get there, say amen. It's in the same book. So let's go up to 6 chapter. Praise God. And it says, but Joshua had said unto the two men that had spied out the country, Go into the harlot's house. I call it faith house. Because in Hebrews, the Bible tells me what? Hebrews, the 11th chapter, verse 31, that Rahab is in the hall of faith. She's in the hall of faith. Because she's listed with Abraham. She listed with all the patriarchs who work out of faith. Right here, and Joshua say, go into the hall of faith house. That's the harlot. Y'all looking at somebody bad, but she's about to be good. Right. Hallelujah. Not only is she going to be good, but she is the grandmother of David. Y'all know who David is, eh? That little fellow who beat the giant? Yeah, that David. But also out of David comes the seed of Christ. You mean to tell me that Christ, great, 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 y'all stop me. Great, 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 grandmama was a harlot? Hello. So you can't base it on your past. to disqualify us.
Come on.
That means we had to be the right pedigree. Hallelujah. We had to have the right lineage. But he of God was using all kinds. I don't know about you. I'm thankful that he used all kinds. And he said, out of this harlot house and bring out this, the woman and all that she has. As you swear unto her, verse 23. Hallelujah. And the young men that were spies went in and brought out Rahab and her father and her mother and her brother and all that she had. Hallelujah. In other words, she up there in Acts now. Me and my whole household shall be saved. Yeah. When you operate in faith, God will work in your whole household. Yeah. Children don't know Christ because you don't know Christ. Because if you know him, you will share him with your children. He said her father, her mother, her brother, and all that she had, and they brought out all the kindred and left them without the camp of Israel. I got to give you a little background on here. It's because God had told Joshua, when you go to Jericho, I want you to walk around the city. I want you to take you seven priests with seven trumpets. And I want you to walk around the city. And when you walk around one time, I want you to blow your horn. And then I want you to do this for 6 days in a row. And then on the seventh day, I want you to walk around seven times and blow your horn. And the people don't say nothing until I tell them to shout. And he said, when you do all these things, guess what's going to happen? The walls of Jericho are going to come falling down. But watch this. Rahab's house was in the walls of Jericho. So God was about to destroy the wall but save her. Don't tell me God is limited in his power. When the whole wall fall down, when they got there to a house in all the rubble, they were still in there shouting and saying, God I serve is a living God. And he saved me in the midst of all this. The Bible shows us that the spies are running up to our house. And the walls done fall down. How we know she was in the walls of the city is because the Bible tells us that she had a scarlet cord that she let the spies down when the gate was closed. So that means she had to be on the outside wall in order for them to get out of the city. Because the city went on lockdown because those spies were like terrorists. You know, they locked the whole city down. But because she was on the outer skirts, they was able to let it down, but when the God brought down the walls, he spared them. In other words, God remember your works. People don't want to hear that, but God remember your works. He know what you do in behalf of his name, and he will honor his promise. If God made a promise to you, baby, bet you a bet. I bet you he's going to keep it. He will keep your promise. If he's giving you a vision, guess what's going to happen? It's going to come to pass. Somebody should be excited right there. Hallelujah. You might have a little bit of complaints. You might have somebody murmuring about it. You might have somebody who's coming up against it. But if God says it's going to come to pass, it's coming to pass.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. When I was on my job at Nevermore in Hampton, and I was about to be promoted, and I was always speaking. I don't know if y'all, anybody remember me. I was a little guy that would walk around with a briefcase. Like I was somebody important. And every time I go to work through the gate, I have my little leather briefcase. And I ain't nothing but a truck driver. I mean a forklift driver. But I had a supervisor mentality. They didn't know the only thing I had in there was my lunch. But I walked through the gates like I was somebody important. In other words, here I gave me a vision. I was going to be a supervisor in that facility. And so I began to act like I began to copy what they was doing. I walked like them in every conversation I had. I'd be right on up in that conversation trying to get information. And he opened up the door. I come to tell you, I became that supervisor. And then I put away my briefcase. Had no more lunch breaks. Sometimes you gotta watch out what you ask for. Hallelujah. But I come to tell you, whatever vision God give you, he'll bring it to pass. Only thing you gotta do is trust God in the process. Anybody wanna trust God in the process? Anybody wanna sell out for their dream in God? I know that God is gonna bring it to fruition. God is gonna manifest. But God will bring you out of a bad place. Anybody ever been suicidal in here? I know y'all don't want to admit. We done been there. I done been there. Them days I was so drunk, and I was going down the road, and my heart broke, and I was like, Lord, just kill me and see how many people come to my funeral. Y'all ain't never had that thought. Come on, just be real. No, nobody never had that thought of wondering how many people come to your funeral. You big dummy. You ain't gonna know.
No, you ain't gonna know.
You'll be dead. In the eighth grade, I had a dream. And I wrote it out on paper. And it was a little play. And I wrote it out about my death. And I was sitting there and I was floating above everybody, seeing all these people sitting out there. And it was just crowded. And people was crying. And I saw this glass thing up front. And the closer I got, the more I began to recognize what was in it. And then I got to the point when I saw it, and it was me. And I wrote the thing up, and the woman said, you get an A, but I got to give you a B minus because of your grammar. He showed me the vision of it, but I was sitting here thinking that, you know, when I die, I'm going to have all these folks, and I'm going to be in the sea. But I come to tell you today, you ain't going to see none of this stuff. So don't let the devil trick you into believing that taking your life. Hallelujah is going to better some stuff. Hallelujah. To me, I used to think that a person who took their life had a lot of courage. But to tell you the truth, I think you're a coward if you do. Amen. It takes more life. It takes more courage to live through some of this hell y'all give up. Amen. Can I get an amen right there? It takes a lot of courage. All the hell on earth, it takes courage to live. Now, y'all getting all messed up because I say hell. Don't go there. Because I ain't cussing. It's definitely in the Bible. And if you don't change your life, it'll never be in you. But because of this, we've been at a low place, and don't think that nobody can use us because we're in a low place. But I come to give you hope today that your life ain't over yet. This is just one page in one chapter. The book ain't finished yet. In the end, if you will read ahead, it say we got the victory. I'm triumphed through Christ. I still got plans for you. I'm glad I didn't throw in the towel. I'm glad I didn't listen to those foolish thoughts that was in my mind. Hallelujah. I thank God I'm sold out now. Anybody else want to be sold out for God? You know you can get into the Hall of Fame too. Or the Hall of Faith. The Bible said the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Hallelujah. That's the day you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And I believe when Jesus Christ comes into your life start changing. Yes. That don't mean everything's going to magically disappear. That don't mean you still, if you know how to smoke, don't mean you want to stop instantly. You got to have a will to resist. The Bible says, submit yourself unto John, that's change. Resist the devil and he shall
flee.
He shall do what?
Flee.
He shall flee from you. Give this testimony and we're going to close out. When I gave my life to Christ, January the 2nd, 1997, I was still at Nevermore working there. I was on the safe behavior team. And I came back off of the New Year break or the Christmas break. And I came back in to tell everybody that was there that I'm saved. And God has saved my life and I thank God for it. I got saved on a Thursday, on that Friday morning, on that Monday morning, I'm praising God. And when, no, I got saved on a Thursday, and that Friday I was at work. Hallelujah. And when I came back, this is what happened. I had a desire. I was like, Lord, then deliver me. I'm free. Because everything, you know, heard your parents, your family, anybody go to church, say, now you're done, everything is gone, and all that. And so now, I was a smoker, you know, doing a pack a day and all that. When I got to work, hallelujah, I had a desire to smoke. Now, I'm saved, but yet still, I wanted that cigarette. And so I went to work, and I done told everybody I'm saved now, And I know I'm supposed to be smoking if I'm saved. That's what the church said. And so therefore, I went in there, and I had a desire, and I wanted to ask somebody. But then if I ask them, they're going to know that I still had this, this affliction in my body.
Yeah.
And so I said, you know what? I'll wait lunch, and I'll buy me another pack. And then after that pack, I'll be finished with it. Anybody ever had a test?
Oh, yeah.
You know, I'm just going to do it one more time, and then after that, I ain't going to do it anymore. Well, the Lord, the Holy Spirit spoke in my spirit. He said, go pray. And there was a little closet in the back where we kept all the medical and safety equipment. And I went back, and I began to pray. I said, Lord, look here. I don't want to be a hypocrite. Teach me. Show me. Give me the script. And the power of God came upon me, and I could feel his presence. And I went back out there, and I had script for the rest of the day. Hallelujah. But when I got home, all hell broke loose. Because there was two cigarettes still sitting in a pack in our house. See, sometimes you need some help. Hallelujah. There was two sitting right in the house. I remember them being on the coffee table in the den. And I walked in there just a whistling. Hallelujah. And I'm going in there. Didn't know. My wife was, she was in there. She was cleaning up whatever she doing. I don't know why she wasn't working that particular day. But anyhow, I came in there. And I looked on the coffee table. And I didn't see her. You know how smokers are. We got to go to all the spots we smoke at. So I went to the room, look on the dresser, still didn't see. I said, let me go check our bathroom. How many smokers know what I'm talking about? I went in there and still couldn't find it. And so after a while, I got bold enough to say, I go to my wife and I say, honey, you seen that pack of Newports I had? And she said, yes. She said, I threw them in the trash can. Hallelujah. Instead of me worrying about someone who's trying to help me, the Lord said, praise me. Hallelujah. He said, you about to get your deliverance. I said, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He began to reveal in my mind the trap of the enemy. Because if I went back and smoked that, I would have continued smoking it. Then next thing you know, I've been back drinking. Next thing you know, I've been back at the pool hall. Next thing you know, I've been fighting and doing all other stuff. There's a setup the devil trying to set you up with. But the moment I started praising God, I felt the power and presence of him, and I was released. Never had a desire to go back at all. I don't believe that God takes stuff away from you. I believe God gives you power to resist. So that's why you might find some people still struggling with stuff. There ain't a reason to judge them. That's a reason to lift them up. Put prayer on them. Help them in prayer. Say, brother, let me pray with you. Sister, let me pray with you. You're struggling in this area, but I'm going to pray with you. Instead of condemning them,
Thank you, God.
God gave you grace.
Yes.
Why can't you give it to somebody else? When you're sold out for God. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
When he deals with your heart, he begins to release things. Amen. While you're standing on your feet.
Hallelujah.
I know this is not your typical service. A typical sermon.
Awesome.
But I just wanted to share when Rahab met God through his people. She sold out for their very testimony. I believe God got testimonies in this place right now that's going to draw some of his people out of their wilderness. God got a testimony in you that's going to pull somebody to him. Do you believe that? Are you the one that want to be used by God? Are you tired of having a pretense of a relationship with him, or do you want to have a relationship with him? If that's you, come now. I just want to pray with you. If you were able to sell out, maybe you was partial way in. You know how some people just be half the way in? Hallelujah. Kind of scrawling it, but now you want to sell out for him? Come on, take that step of faith. This is not an invitation to join us.